Daydreamers, and welcome back to a new episode of Dishonored 2! Oh my god, it's fucking itchy! I'll show you why. Give me a second. Yes! I got my hair cut. I know it's skippy, but... Shut my hair out! My mom in this life did it. I look so awesome, but it's still fucking itchy! I just got it done. Sorry, I just... It's a scratcher! I can't stop scratching. Don't take that completely off. It just itches. So, I know we just finished Dishonored 2, but since I didn't get an answer from you, from my colleagues, I'm kidding, my dear friends from the other side, they have decided that since you guys didn't really answer, and I'm actually going to see what happens if I put it all the way up. Visuals. I'm going to put it up. Advanced settings. I'm going to put it up to... medium. We'll just put it up to medium. I'm gonna put it up to 12 with that one. I know you guys are watching me do this, but I wanna get everything, like, gone up just to see how it goes. If it does horribly, then we know how bad it is. But for now, at least we know everything is cool. It was at 80 before. I'm gonna put it up to 85. Brightness is okay. Yep, everything's back. It's okay. Window mode, that's okay. Not applicable. It's good. Yeah, everything's balanced. Triple buffering? Okay, I just wanted to. I know I did bad. I shouldn't have done that. But. Yes! Because I want to put up the settings, see how good it does without screwing anything up. Hey! That's gone away! That's gone away! It's part of his cloak! His clothes! Yay! Things are gotten a lot better. You can see detail and definition on mommy! Yes! Possibly one day I might play this on Ultra, but I'm not going to expand too much onto it because I don't want it to skip and do bad things. But today, in our awesome new adventure, we are going to play as mommy on Low Chaos because it was requested. And I'm going easy because I still don't understand anything just yet. So, oh. You know, let us do this anyways.
I remember training with my father in the years after the rat plague.
Aw, man.
Someday, he said, our enemies will come for you.
I'm actually gonna take this off because we already have it on there. I'm going to do it anyways, but not with your guys' watching. So I'm just gonna do it because I want to, okay?
Be all back.
I did so much faster in this part because I knew what I was doing. I didn't even know because the thing was like, go as Jordan, going all over the place. I didn't know how to use it and how to go everywhere. But now that we know what we're doing, hold on one second. Just making sure. It seems to do that a lot. Are you kidding me? It really is. That was off center. Anyways, here we go. Playing as mommy.
Why do we celebrate the anniversary of an assassination? 15 years ago, in the middle of a plague that nearly destroyed Dunwall, a paid killer assaulted the palace where I was born and stabbed my mother in the heart. In the aftermath, the men who sent the assassin tried to use me as a pawn in a game of power. They would have succeeded, but my father, Corvo Atano, hunted them down and cut their conspiracy to pieces. All these years later, am I the ruler my mother wanted me to be? Now, we face a new crisis. A monster the papers are calling the Crown Killer has been picking off my enemies and dressing it up like my father and I are responsible.
It's Imi. This is Imi's
son. I don't know whether to get on a ship and sail to the opposite side of the world, or to have everyone around me executed.
Pretty much they started it.
Bright light!
This is a lot better definition of detail.
Watch your step, Majesty. I'm not looking forward to all the ceremony today. Your signet ring. There, you're ready. Thank you, Alexei. Open the doors.
Imperial Majesty, Emily Caldwin.
Jeez, what kind of dickhead?
Royal subjects, we're going through a difficult time, but today we honor my mother, the late Jessamine Caldwin. May her memory survive through the ages.
Emily.
You look tired, Father.
Every year, I think the anniversary of Jessamine's death will be easier, but it never is.
I wish Mother was still the Empress. I don't think I'm very good at this.
You're still learning. Don't worry about the rabble-rousers, and we'll catch the Crown Killer, eventually.
People are saying it's you, that these assassinations are a misguided effort to protect me.
No, someone's trying to make us look guilty by targeting your enemies.
I wish I could just run away from all this.
Sometimes you do. You think I don't know about your nights out on the rooftops? Courage. The ceremony will be over soon.
Royal protector and father. I should have passed a law against that combination of titles years ago.
I realize what they said. That was funny. Funny.
Your Majesty, before we begin the day's observances, we have an unexpected visitor. The Duke of Cirkonos.
Ramsay says the Duke is bringing special gifts.
That's intriguing.
Luca Abel, Duke of
Cirkonos! Right? Ah, God!
Little soldiers? Amazing.
What is this, Ramsay? I didn't authorize those things.
Your Imperial Majesty and Royal Protector Corvo Atano, a native of our homeland. Cirkonos offers condolences on this sorrowful day, and gifts to remind you of our nation. The rising star on the southern horizon.
We thank you, Your Grace.
Save your thanks. For now, I give you the greatest gift of all. Family. I present the lost sister of Jessamine Caldwin. Your rightful empress, Delilah Caldwin.
Impossible.
My mother had a sister?
My dearest niece. Hello.
It's not true.
My father was Emperor Yuhorn Jacob Caldwin, and Jessamine was my younger sister. At the time of her death, I wasn't ready to make myself known to you, and I was forced to leave Dunwall. But now I'm home.
If you really are my mother's sister, you're welcome to stay as long as you like.
Little Sparrow, blackened by bad memories, I'm here to relieve you of your crown. My father's promise, whispered in secret so many years ago, is now fulfilled.
Watch your tongue. Emily Caldwin is the daughter of Empress Jessamine Caldwin.
She completely ignored his
Royal
voice.
Protector. How naive to think you could get away with these murders. Living in my palace has protected you, but that's over. Hear me, all of you. Your rightful Empress has returned.
All hail the Empress Delilah. first of her name. Arrest Emily Caldwin and her father for the Crown Killer murder.
What?
Ah! Oh!
Sword can't steal my heart.
I need to rewatch that. Yeah, obviously I'm gonna be playing as Emily this time, but we're still going pacifist, darling. We're still going the way of mommy!
Until then, you'll be kept out of trouble.
I'll lock Lady Emily in her chambers, and I'll bring her to Coldwell prison until her trial.
Love you for what?
I lost it all when I was a boy, so now I wear this uniform, and I send 20-year-olds out to patrol the Rose Gardens instead of drinking with the men from the shooting club.
And yet you're talking to me about that! What the fuck?
Captain Ramsay, I heard shouting. Lady Emily, what happened?
I'll be all Captain Mayhew.
No!
Well, that's the Royal Protector's fancy weapon. What kind of sword folds in half?
Jesus! Why the fuck, you just sick, twisted bastard! Get your hands off me! God!
There's a legend in the Tower Guard about the Empress's last resort, a safe room inside your chambers holding enough gold to buy a good-sized island. They say that this ring is one of the only two keys to exist.
Now that I re-see it like this, my story is identical to the...
What happened? Oh. Alexei. The throne room. Father.
The story does.
I can do alone. I need to get out of here.
Mom! Shut up! Let me speak! You've been talking for too long! Okay, the story actually makes sense.
Bastards are working with Ramsay and the Duke of Sirkonos.
The funny thing is, though, is that... shut up! Is that the whole thing of this story actually makes a lot of sense with what my story goes on to be. I kind of made a little bit loopy a bit. Dun, 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 dun. I'm actually also going to be looking for a lot of secrets. And you guys can enjoy reading this stuff. I'm going to be reading this on my free time when I do my own adventure! Not everything is going to be going the way it should be. But hopefully something will go right. Dun, 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 dun. Joy. I could. Yes, I know.
Watch it, glue!
And pick a place to hide for a while? I need time to think.
Just enjoy yourself.
How many times have I looked at that skyline? It feels like everything just changed.
Jump and attempt to hit the water. Why is that thing always down? I do that.
Delilah is some sort of witch.
Lady Emily.
Yay!
Where's the Royal Protector? There's a coup underway.
My father is... he's imprisoned, for lack of a better word.
You've got to get out of the tower, through your safe room. There was a captain earlier today, down at the docks, looking for the Royal Protector. Find her. Get out of Dunwall.
Alexei, I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Alexei, no!
Damn it. I need to pee.
Well, go pee, damn it! I'm gonna be back in this room anyways. What the frick? Little tiny secrets here and there. In fact, I didn't even check one thing. Over there. Requested. I didn't see this before. I skipped it. Okay, let's read it. Perfect timing. Captain Mayhew, you don't know me, but I've got to tell Lord Protector that I have urgent need of his time. I'm carrying a message that has to be delivered face to face. Tell him I'm working with Anton Sokolov, an old friend. All the boats are being sent away from the docks, but I'll delay as long as I can. Tell Lord Corvo to find me there. My ship is called the Dreadful Whale, Megan Foster.
I never saw that before.
Door, nice. Some goodies. Stuff. This could be Corvo's room. I called Corvo's room the bathroom. Where is Corvo's room, by the way? I never even wanted to ask that. Does Corvo just sleep downstairs or something? Get me food! God, I hate that sound. Who doesn't? Everything is going to be silent.
Times are hard. You're the ruler of four nations, and I won't pretend to understand the pressure you're under. Only you and your mother before you could know what that's like. Whoever's killing off your enemies is doing so for calculated effect, undermining us. And I do know what it's like to be blamed for murders you didn't commit, but trust me, we'll find this crown killer. And they'll pay. Tomorrow is the anniversary of her death. A sad day for sure. But I want you to remember all that's happened over the last 15 years. You've held on to the throne.
I never heard.
And you've done what you thought was right for the people of the Empire. You drained the flooded district, kept the gangs in check, and yesterday we launched a magnificent ship bearing Jessamine's name. You're becoming the sovereign your mother wanted you to be, and I'm proud of you.
Oh, I never found that before! I'm so glad I found it now! Gold!
Well, we got goodies. There's a giant tub. We'll find Grandpa's room soon. I wish to find it. Royal Protector. Historical record of government protect. Then some ranks in Victorian. I can't read that. Corvo Tano, accused of assassinating the Empress he was sworn to protect. How unlikely he would not only overcome this shame. Yeah, the shame, but then redeem himself so fully as to be named Royal Protector and yet another Empress. To yet another Empress. Those of us at the College of Histories were too fast to use pen against him. The pen is mightier than the sword. Yet let us not blame historians for the evidence against Atano was nearly overwhelming. First, he is the only royal protector ever to have been born of an island other than Gristral. I still can't pronounce it. His foreignness is not itself a crime, but added to the suspicions, the most forgiving of which was that he lacked the capacity to fully understand his duties. What? Never mind. Second, he was caught quite red-handed with blooded weapon kneeling over the body of Empress Jessamine. Of course, it turns out that even this damning evidence was part of a clever plot to destroy the Empress and remove Atano from interfering with ongoing plans of the Lord Regent's conspirators. And while I admit to publishing what are now clearly incorrect conclusions regarding Corvo Atano, I will not, as some of my colleagues have done, regain my position at our organization, but instead I reassert myself in the... What the freak is with these long words? Of weeding out a fact from fiction to produce the most silent histories possible. How come I have to read all that and no pages were turned? People than more normally. Who knows? But what secrets we will find? That you could carry them, Emily. You're quite damn strong for very small. Goddess! He's perched really well on the chair! Crown Killer strikes again. So this must have been Piero who had done this. Enjoy the reading. I only can read certain things that have to do with Grandpa, Emily. Grandpa, important things that are not obvious, secrets, anything that has to do with the outsider. Why do you keep opening? And shit like that. Close, god damn it! It hurts when I bend my neck backwards.
The
throne room blocked off, we should have the time we need. Just stay here and stall anyone who comes by. I'll be back when I've searched the royal chambers. Assuming I don't accidentally block myself in this damn city.
We'll cover for you if anyone from the Duke's party returns. Exciting. Everything's changing.
What is this thing?
The natural order is reasserting itself. The Ramses once hosted the king and queen of Morley. Did you know that? I spent my childhood playing with the buntings and the boils and the cream of the diamond.
And very soon you'll be back at the top, Captain.
What? It almost sounds like the certain guys just sound like Corvo. There's some guys that really do sound like Corvo. It's weird. Move your bloomin' ass! I didn't do good, so we load again! Cause nothing's worth it without anything freaking up! Fidging. You know, from now on, I might as well just say fidge as an added on word, because the outsider. Or fidge. Fig. Fig. It's a wonderful fruit, by the way. I've actually always thought it was something healthy, but. Good night, Morley.
This won't leave my hand again.
Oh. Mama! Here, you want to have a perfectly good seat? Here, sit down with your friend. There you go. I'm kidding. You're coming with me. You get a special place in your heart. You don't have to sit next down to him. You get someplace special. Where's that, you ask? Well, you really, 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 really wanted to see that safe. I will give it to you.
But you're not sitting on my bed in the process. Oh no. You stay off my bed.
Anton Sokolov made this lock.
Open sesame! Here you go.
And boom! Do you like it? I know you're not if you were sitting on the pillow, then you would be Japanese style. Don't ask questions, just accept what you have. Once I close the door, I'll be right back. I think I already- Oh! I missed a few things. Shut up. It's a little adventure, once in a while. Close everything. Okay. But I have to do this.
I can't dally.
Come
no
on.
Time for that now.
It's fun! Oh, come on! It's nice and comfortable! It's nice to relax once in a great while. I mean, yeah, I know you're right now, but seriously, you need to chillax!
Smoke some weed, I don't care, relax! Don't smoke weed under the age, by the way, but, if you guys do, originally, Do not smoke weed while playing this game. I recommend it during Deadpool, but not this one. It doesn't work.
Now you've got what you wanted, Ramsay. The Imperial suite atop Dunwall Tower. Stay put until this is all set straight, Ramsay. Enjoy the rations and well water, sleeping next to a fortune.
You'll have everything you've always dreamed of! With an exception, of course. Can't get out! Give me that. Whispers from the void. Why did I see this? Something about the void and everything. Dun, 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 dun. Scope of story. A person has stepped beneath the carriage wheels. This could help me with my story. If I saw something that had to do with the outsider, then I would be able to read it. Okay, I'm reading it because the outsider's in it. These little glimpses of the void in the dreams were described by those awakened from comas. Wait, what? Okay, let me reread that. These little glimpses of the void in the dreams were described by those awakened from comas are not limited to select few. Grandpa, do you mind if I nearly kill you and make you go through a coma? In my story, I have a point where he was trying to save his grandson from being assassinated, but in the process, supposedly, quote-unquote, killing himself, he got shot into the eye and he lost his eye, but the outsider gave him a new eye and gave him a part of him. Since we've already seen the first part, and if you haven't, you gotta see the other one before watching this. Spoilers! But yes, there's a lot of stuff that has to do on here about a lot of, things. You'll find out in this version that you'll be hearing a lot of part of my story. And yes, so Grandpa's going to have a little bit of a problem, so whatnot. In my interviews, I've gleaned that there is not a single citizen without such visions at one time or another. This, then, must be a real place. Not folklore or misdelusion. We've been there! Anybody who watches this game knows that the existence is futile. Or knows that all this shit is not futile. What? I don't know. I can't word. I don't word well. I can't speak English. And then it's. Perhaps it was not. Perhaps this is not. Wait, I've read it wrong. And then this ring of role place, not folklore. So since perhaps it exists deep below the earth or above it. Perhaps it is right next to us, but hidden. Like heaven? Heaven is all around us. Some trick of the light or wondrous Christian bars us from fully knowing it. And we all but wait for a natural philosopher to unlock the phenomenon to show us how to see it at will. But when revealed, it is not to be fearsome place any longer. Like aliens? Not the distant and special realm described in the myth of the outsider.
Darling!
Sorry. Fangirl moment. Let me be. I need to have my moment. It will be strange, yes. Even unsettling. But nevertheless, it will be a new realm for us to explore and eventually conquer. No, you cannot! What new treasures wait us there? Are the lakes made of liquid? No. Liquid diamond? No. The clouds of weightless silver gas? No. And what things we would learn? No. Tune in next time! I'm kidding. But trust me, we've been there already. We know how it goes. Nothing is safe or
We're all dead anyways. I know exactly how it is. Where is she? I never even saw this before. Flush the toilet because I'm freaking weird. What's this? Is this Emily's place and Corvo gets the one upstairs? I don't know. Oh man. No. Lord Corvo, if you're reading this letter as per your role of protection functions, know that I am joking and perfectly aware that leaf tobacco is forbidden in Gristol. What? What the fuck? You're... Oh! I see. Oh, God. She smokes this shit? Or is this Grandpa? Is this Grandpa's hiding place or something? I don't know. Doesn't say. In Our Times Part 1. It's enjoy the little bits of immortality of Grandpa Corvo! I need a book about this too! And I mean, everything that has to do with the Outsider, I want one book. Everything that has to do with Corvo Tano is in another book. It's for story-wise sake. I know I'm stuck in here still trying to figure out so many different things. That is cute! Hey! I know you! Wait, what the?
That one day you'll be grown up. And I wonder what you'll remember of these years. Will you recall your time as a child with fondness?
He found it!
Were there too many caretakers, formal dinners, and lessons about boring old history? Maybe the precious hours we spent together will shine brighter. Time captured now and then with your mother and with Corvo, who was always close to my heart. Of rats and plague will be nothing more than a passing shadow.
How many things I have read about?
A crisis come and passed, weathered by your mother and her advisors. You'll sit on the throne someday, and will do well, I hope.
It's behind.
It's a tricky life, full of responsibility and peril. It was not your choice to be the daughter of an empress. But I believe you'll rise to the challenge. Stay good-hearted, Emily. Keep drawing and telling stories. And only share your power with those you truly trust.
If only I could talk to my mother one more time.
One thing I'm so glad, and I mean I'm so glad, is that this version, I get to find all the little hidden secrets and doohickeys and shit. It's so sweet. I'm just still confused. Whose bed is this? Is it Grandpa's?
Old Samuel made this. I'm glad he didn't live to see me driven out of Dunwall Tower.
I swear. This looks like something that Grandpa would do or something like that. Unless... I don't know. Things that we don't know. Lord Protector Corvo and stuff. It's crazy, fell. Anything that has to do with the Outsider? I mean, I would love to read this, but you guys don't want to hear me constantly talk. First episode! What it's all about is annoying ramblings and constantly reading books about Grandpa and the Outsider and Mommy! And Grandma!
The reserves won't help against Delilah, even if I had a way to carry it all out of here.
Well, you can only carry so much.
I'll need this.
Just a little bit goes a long way.
god. Wait a minute, is this... this is Mom or Emily? Maybe they had to keep it secret. It looks just like the one that was in a... I skipped this for a reason. I'm sorry, guys. Yes!
I have a feeling I'll need these.
That's cool. Grandpa got more than that! Strikes again. Bone charms! Enjoy. I think it's the same thing. There's some things that are. Come here! I want you.
I take these.
Yeah, Grandpa told you not to start jumping on certain things. But you might find some great secrets! Let's go! There's nothing around here anymore. I took all the stuff that I could carry. And read all the books that I could read. Unfortunately... this looks familiar. Unfortunately,
Until I understand this, I have to go into hiding. I should make my way to the docks.
Old history textbook. Ah, there's more. First fleet of vessels that made it. Oh, enjoyed a little bit of this. Handwritten note at the end of the chapter. Emily. Half of the merchant's whales fell to the rough coast of East Merley. You can still see the remains of the ships poking out of the water should you ever visit Aron. Also, there's no mention here that it was Sokolov himself who designed the first steam-powered whaling ships. He'll tell you all about it if you ask. And he's sober. Ah.
What would my old governess say? Callista would probably tell me to sit up straight and to marry Wyman. She'd ask me when the War of the Four Crowns ended. 1625.
You still couldn't help but say it! I mean, there's actually also a difference between Mina and Adam. In the story, I have kind of like twins. Basically, their little life pretty much replifies off of my life. My brother and I were born same day, 2 years apart, and I kind of replicated that a little bit on Mina and Adam. Adam took the name Caldwin and he became emperor. Mina just took the name Atano because Grandpa wanted to hide her from the world because of how she was appeared, birth, world, and yeah. But an explanation of what I'm trying to say is that Adam learns more on history, and he loves history. He loves to learn about all the lessons and everything. He will, off the top of his head, he will answer any questions that have to do with the histories and lessons of the world and all that stuff. And I'm just saying this off the basics of the story that I made, not on here. It's a fan fiction thing. Shut up and let me have my time of... yeah. But Mina, the reason why I say about her specialty is that she's really good at things that are fiction and nonfiction. Allow me to explain.
Gotta get out of Dunwall.
Gotta get out of Dodge, darling. Let's go. The reason why I'm saying this is that Mina has actually studied a lot on certain special things that are either just fairy tales, and she pretty much read every single book of fairy tales and will read them 5,000 times, like Belle from Beauty and the Beast. And, she has this huge...
I've gotta get away. I should talk to the captain of that ship.
And she has, this huge love for learning more interest in space and time. Why do I say that? It's because it's also her grandfather. It's also because of Corvo, who pretty much told her she might need to learn something rather than just
somehow Delilah turned my father to stone. I will find a way to undo it.
It's the power of love. I'm gonna start singing fucking Sailor Moon after a while, trust me. The power of love compels you. But the reason why I say that is, Mina has actually studied, learned, and examined a lot about time and space. She is a special, unique child. And, I can't drop assassinate you. Why? Because I'm a super-duper secret stealther.
Oh, I hate this wool. It itches like mad. Why can't I wear my regular clothes?
No, I froze again. I'm gonna save it. Even notice me. Turn around. It's a bit late.
You're not fit for the watch uniform.
Hey, he's sleeping. Leave him be, Mom. But yeah, that's why I say Mina's special. She wants to learn these things about supernatural stuff, time and space and everything. And Adam is more interested in becoming emperor and learning all these things about life and other things. And it actually makes sense in realistic time. Because I myself am interested in supernatural shit.
The Duke's men.
I'm interested.
I have bad news. Ramsey's missing. Corporal Moore checked the royal quarters, and Emily Caldwin has apparently fled the tower. We've got to find him. That's it. You've got your orders. Spread out and find the fugitive. We're in this with the Duke of Cirkano, sink or swim. There's no way to turn back now.
So, I'm special, and I like looking at supernatural stuff, as my older brother likes to do history. Instead, my older brother's more interested in song. Why do I say that? He's a singer.
Forget about that kiss.
That kiss!
Former Empress Emily Caldwin has been accused of high crimes against the state. Anyone caught harboring her is equally guilty of treason. Hard times. Hard times. Gotta be on the lookout.
Must be super duper secret and stealthy. Turn around would be nice.
Oh well.
Come here.
come here and go to Sleepy Pie. Because that's what you deserve. I'm going to save it here, and hopefully, bad things don't happen! And now I don't have to worry too much. I have yet to be spotted! I am doing good. This is one of the best.
Oh my god. And a pile of sleepy people. On a dead body. Well, it's not my fault. You all just got tired and started having an orgy party. I don't know. You guys are weird. I have no idea why. Dun, 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 dun. You guys are weird. I don't know what's wrong with them. They just are.
Huh?
Somebody left it in the draft.
Case. I'm gonna save it here.
Who opened this door?
I don't know.
Maybe the wind or something.
As a hippo, I'll take the coins. You give me your shit if you can, because I have to take it for reasons untold. And what's this? Boom. I'm gonna just keep singing that until you guys are finished reading. Actually, you guys might as well. I'll take that because it's copper wire. Take that, but I'm not gonna use it unless it's important. If only there was river crust, then I would be able to use it. And then Emily will know what to do with it.
Just being very, very quiet.
We're just hunting rabbit, Mommy. Expecting that. No, nothing. Well, at least I know that there's really nothing to do.
do over here that much because I just knocked almost everybody out and they didn't even notice me. But we are going to do this. Garvani.
Who's there? That's Emily Caldwin.
No, it's not! You're seeing things! I don't know what you're doing, but you're seeing things. You're blind. I wonder, does she put on the mask thing?
It's kind of dry. I could really go for a whiskey or something. Maybe one of them two penny drinks.
Good night. Good night! I'll go searching for it. It's right over here. 451. 451. 451. 451. Ah, damn it! At least it looks a lot better than it. This is actually on medium, and you can see this better. Oh my god! Oh, I can feel the texture of this thing! Oh. Silver and gold. Silver and gold. What's the difference? Okay. I wish I could be able to finish this episode in time, but unfortunately, I'm actually doing a second episode later today, so we're gonna finish this up today. You guys will enjoy it. This is actually just the redox of Pasifists and Nobody Knows Where I Am episode, so I'm just going to be finishing up here, and as I do that, I'm going to be doing the outro right now. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please leave a... I want that! Thank you. Please leave a like and a comment down below on what you think of this episode. I hope you're having a fantastic evening. God damn it, Mom. I think you're drunk. Go home. We'll talk about that later, Mom. Just don't get upset at me. Oh. Taking that. And I don't see any more things, but I think that is all that I can carry for today. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please leave a like and a comment down below on what you think of this episode. I hope you're having a fantastic day, because I am... Oh... That was Billy! Poor kid. Oh, man, Billy, I am so sorry. We got you out of a bad habit and everything last week. Oh, God, I feel bad. Anyways, keep on dreaming, because one day your dreams will come true. Hugs and kisses! Huggles! Mwah! Let me save it here, too. And let us hang out in the next episode.